In 1979, somewhere during that time, by then there were a few people who studied with us. They did their degree, their postgraduate, they did. They became lecturers. Some of them were doing PhD. They were senior students. There were a batch of about 78 or 9 students on whom Swami invested a lot of time. He treated them as his own friends. He would give weightage for whatever they say. He filled them with love. When he gives so much of love, he also sometimes tests us. Have they digested it? Has it helped them to grow? Or has it fed their ego and they are ruining themselves? If such a thing happens, he wants to correct. So that was the context. He stopped talking suddenly to those people, those 7 or 8 of them, all of them. And he said, "I know, I say you want to go away to your places. And go away. Why do you stay here with me?" And they had never thought of it. Maybe there is in their hearts, in the seed form, a thought to go. I don't know. But as far as I could see, there was nothing like that. But Swami said, "Stop talking." Probably it was a test. This went on. Before Swami went for darshan, Swami would come and sit in a room. And quite a few students will be in that room, a few VIPs and a few teachers and all that. During this particular time, all these 7 or 8 of them will be there. There will be tense atmosphere in the room. Swami would not talk a word, they would not talk anything. And no one dare to disturb unless it is very urgent, which doesn't hurt Swami. This went on for almost 1 week. One of them, after these 7 days of this kind of situation, made bold and with a lot of love, lot of kind of respect, he told Swami, Swami, "Memu meeku chaala thondaristunnam Swami. Meeru santoshangane leru Swami. We are giving you a lot of trouble. You are not at all happy. And if you feel, Swami, that if we go away to our places, if you will be happy, we will go away, Swami. It is difficult for us, Swami, but we don't mind. We want Swami to be happy, Swami." Such a great prayer, great request, Swami said. He said, "Is that all that you have understood, I say, of Swami? For how long have you stayed? Where will you go? You will go to your places where Swami is not there. Do you mean to say that Swami is not there in your place? Is Swami not omnipresent? How dare you say that you go to a place where I am not there? I am everywhere. That you should know first. Secondly, will Swami be happy when you go away from me? Is that for that purpose I have trained you and I have given so much of love to you? To drive you away to your places? No. I will be happy only when you satisfy me in your behavior, conduct, growth, evolution. I want you to be good leaders, ideal people. That's what I want, rather than you go away to your places." And it was after Swami talked this, there was a stunned silence. Everyone felt the divinity revealing himself.